Oh my goodness, I got another box. I think we should open it and see what I got, okay? What do you think? Yeah, so I got this thing on eBay. I was looking at another one, and then I kind of made an offer on one. It wasn't as good, and then I saw this one, and it just hit. It just hit with like some charity was selling it, and I said, "Oh, $54," and it was like really good, and it included batteries, which I'm not going to use in it because they're Duracells and they suck, but it included the batteries. I said, "What the heck, you know, $54." Let me show you. Oh, I double boxed it too. I can't even believe this. Have to read the newspaper later. Yeah, it's good. He's got the Duracells, which I'm not crazy about Duracells because they always end up leaking. But I could use these in a flashlight or something. What? March 2017? Yeah, they're going to the trash. But here it is. The fact is, let me throw these away now. Give me a break. Great. This one's 2015. You gotta be kidding me. I mean, these things usually start leaking. I don't like Duracells anymore. I like Energizers and Rayovacs. And I like public supermarkets alkaline. But these things are like, oh, come on. Why would he include battery from 2015? What is wrong with people? Anyway, let's get this thing out, okay? Well, the main thing is that he didn't leave them in the radio. That's like the main thing, you know? So, this is great. I gotta show you this. This is great. Yeah, this here is a GE Super Radio. One of the original ones. This is one of the original ones before they even called it a super radio, but it is. See, they marketed this like when you originally bought this, they had a like a sticky piece of plastic on here that said super radio on it. And this one was before they had the tweeter. But that's okay. A lot of people don't like the tweeter. They say it's a little too bright. So this is okay. I mean, this is a good radio here. It looks pretty good. There's a little mark here that wasn't in the picture. It's like something stuck on there. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, maybe I'm going blind or something, but I didn't notice the mark on the glass. Maybe it was how the picture was. Or maybe he banged it. You're gonna have to look at the eBay picture again. But anyway, it's not that bad. I guess I could get another plastic cover for it, maybe. But besides that, the radio is basically perfect. And this is a General Electric 7-2880B, as in Bravo. And looks really good. Antenna's good. Flip it around. And yeah, the battery case is good, and got the power cord and stuff, you know. But I think I'm gonna put some batteries in it, see what the hell it does. Yeah, I like these Publix batteries, always been good, they never leaked. I don't know who makes them, but they're good, you know. Put them all in there, got some brand new ones. Okay, got the last one. Oh, came alive. Dude, it's got good bass to it. Okay, these super radios, even though it doesn't say super radio, it really is a super radio. It says here, high selectivity. Here it says long range, just like the old Zeniths. And typically there's the power switch.
Top.
Say God bless.
860 AM WAEC Atlanta.
The opinions expressed during the sponsored programs on this.
Sounds pretty good. It's got my favorite program here too. Bass and treble. Oh, it must be FM there. Let's try FM. Yeah, they play good music on this Asian station here. They got good singers. Okay, let's see. The rock and roll station is kind of loud. It's got pretty good bass there.
And I know she thinks I'm never coming home.
This past Friday,
if you love it, magic night.
Well, oh, can you come?
Querer probar algo de ti pa no olvidar.
Yeah, you know, these radios, you know, people get them for the AM. You know, the FM sounds pretty good, but people basically buy them to get the AM, because the AM's really good. Okay, so I have to try this out at nighttime. I listen to some DX, see what it's doing, you know? Yeah, I think that's right there is 1500. I think it's like pretty accurate there. Let me try it down here.
WSB News time is 4:03.
Tomorrow, Atlanta's morning news by Clark Tower.
Okay, 7:50 is about right in the middle there. Supposed to be. Okay, so the dial seems pretty good. Okay, so in the meantime, I'm going to check that little blemish there. I didn't see it in the photo, but then again, maybe I just didn't see it. But it's a good radio, though. I'm going to check it when it gets dark out.
They sit at a computer and they basically come up with this stuff.
Totally. Yeah.
No, I don't buy it.
Yeah.
And I don't buy it.
You know what? Well, I'll tell you what.
The Lockmeister Orb.
The name of Unirock, and he has exposed a lot.
Okay,
of
so I was like, I'm listening to WTAM
doing things live on screen
from Cleveland. It's coming in really good. Really like that.
Most of these people, they don't want to talk to
I mean, it's really clear. Now, I could see how this could use a, like a tweeter. But some people say they don't like the tweeters, like on the Super Radio 2 and Super Radio 3. But some people actually change the crossover between the woofer and the tweeter. Makes it sound a little better.
Q is
the sound is very warm on this thing.
Social experiment. It's been going on for some time now.
I like it. Maybe it's a lot of MOSFETs or something they used. I don't know.
There's going to be some sycophants that are going to do something in the name of
snoring and leaking air may be keeping you up all night.
Evenings has really helped me grow my understanding and grow my faith. Catholic Answers is my favorite program. I'm excited about having a Catholic radio station in Atlanta and want to keep it here. I accepted
Atlanta.
The invitation.
Look at the polling.
That seems pretty sensitive. Hey, what I was thinking of is this. What I need to do is a shootout between this Super Radio 1 and the Super Radio 3 I got. because this radio uses variable condensers, or capacitors as the modern folks call them. And then the Super Radio 3 uses varactor tuning. And I heard that the this has a lower noise floor than the Super Radio 3. But I was just thinking about that. So I'm going to make another video to show how this little puppy compares to the Super Radio 3. And I can tell you right now, this looks a lot better. So it's got to work better because it looks a lot better. I mean, this is kind of heavy. It's heavy duty. It looks nice. I think it's well made. I have to look it up when this was made, but the Super Radio 3 I got was made in 2002, I think, 2003. And now I heard that the RCA version, the new one of those, is like junk. So I'm going to tune. I'm going to see if I can find something. I'll shut off and come back. Okay, this is KRMG, I think he said, in Tulsa, Oklahoma. That's pretty good, because I'm in an undisclosed location in middle north Georgia. But that sounds pretty good for Tulsa.
This is News 102.3 KRMG, where Tulsa turns first for breaking news, severe weather, and red alert traffic.
Live team coverage of Tulsa's news starts now.
Ooh, I like that.
It's 10 o'clock comes in Tulsa, good. 42 degrees.
10 o'clock in Tulsa.
The KRMG 24-hour Fox News Center. I'm Mike Downing with team coverage of our top stories. Well, the forecast looks good for the next couple of days, but you're not going to get to keep those warm temperatures for the weekend.
No.
Things actually stay above average through Friday, and then the coldest air we have seen since last January comes charging in. We'll see a little light rain late Friday night. As temperatures fall, we'll see wind-blown light snow on Saturday.
You know, it sounds real good.
Accumulation possible.
It sounds real good.
Temperatures give more and below
bass.
Zero wind chills will be our number
that's
one.
That's like too much bass.
That's Aaron Jen, Fox 23, Chief Meteorologist James Adelot, and he'll be back with the forecast at the end of this news. Also, just breaking news, about 20 minutes ago, we had an earthquake again in Oklahoma. This time, it was about 28 miles northwest of Ponca City.
Wow.
Reports are that it was a 4.0 magnitude earthquake. It happened specifically at about 9:34 this evening.
Yikes.
Well, if there are any damage reports, we'll be bringing to you a little bit later
on
this evening.
I wonder if that's fracking going on, you know what I'm saying?
The downtown boom continues, despite the fact that population growth for the city has been basically flat. There are dozens of projects recently completed, underway.
Oh, yeah, that there is, that was in the picture that I got, that mark there. I didn't see it, but, you know, it's a little chip in the in this heavy plastic. Yeah, it's too bad, but, yeah. It was in the picture. I didn't notice it when I bought it. Okay, you know, so it's working pretty good. So, I'm going to do a shootout video between Super Radio 1 and a Super Radio 3. Let's see how they work. Take it easy, friends. Take it easy. Have a nice day. God bless. Take it easy. Have a nice evening. Keep warm. Keep warm. Watch any earthquakes that are coming, man. I don't know what's going on there in Tulsa. 4.0. Drilling, maybe there's too much fracking there. I don't know what's going on with that. Man, I hope you're okay out there. Okay, so anyway, have a good day, have a good evening. Take it easy, have a nice weekend. I'll see you soon, take it easy. Lockmeister, signing off.
Just one day after a 3.6 magnitude earthquake, and once again before the 4.0 that happened this evening northwest of Ponca City. Well, Tulsa's most accurate. And
yeah, a lot of earthquakes out there. Yikes, I think I'd be moving, you know what I'm saying? I think he spoke by.